Oh, you thought I was actually going to take a break? Bro, I'm on like a 15-day upload streak right now. I haven't done this in years. My inner YouTube is firing on all cylinders right now. This is monumental. And what impeccable timing, because I just finished reacting to the entire NF album yesterday, and I wasn't really sure what videos to make in the meantime while I work on the album review. And then my guy Dax texts me last night. He's like, yo, just dropped a brand new song, mind checking it out? And it has been a solid minute since I've reacted to Dax on this channel, so it works out perfectly. So that's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be looking at Dax's brand new song, To Be a Man. Here we go. All right, it literally has been probably over a year since I've reacted to him. Crazy.
I can't hide myself.
Oh, we got some singing.
I don't expect you to understand. I just hope I can explain.
What's my guy crying right now?
What it's like to be a man. It's a lonely road. And they don't care about what you know. It's not about how you feel, but what you provide inside that home.
Yeah. Yo, I'm liking the direction. This is like a men's mental health awareness kind of song. That's nice. I was literally just talking to my boxing coach about this not too long ago, about how men are kind of looked at as these pillars of strength. Like, you're not supposed to have feelings. What? Feelings? What are those? You can't have those. You're supposed to be strong. You're supposed to be burly. You're supposed to be this concrete foundation that we go to. You're not supposed to cry. You're not supposed to be in your feels about certain things. And I like that he says, you know, they don't care about how you feel. They just care about what you provide inside of the home. Like I said, you're this foundation for them. You're not supposed to cry, okay? Don't show the tears. My man was literally crying in his truck, in his driveway, so he wouldn't cry in front of his family. That's the stigma that is surrounded by men right now. Like, that is what is expected. And that's crazy. That's crazy. Let's go. Let's hear all about it. Open your ears. Let's go.
Yeah, I know this life can really beat you down. You wanna scream, but you won't make a sound. Got so much weight that you've been holding, but won't show any emotion. As a man that goes unspoken, now we can't cry when life gets hard. Unconditional love for women, children, and dogs. We know that we just have to play our parts, and don't nobody give a damn about our broken hearts.
Again, just kind of going on that same notion, like, people just glance over feelings of men. Like, you're just supposed to come home, play your part. My guy was drinking on the couch just to cope with all these feelings that he has. And we don't even know what his feelings are. We just know that he has them. And it's, man. All right, this is super relatable for me. I know that because, you know, I get on here on the internet and I make videos for you guys. I rarely show any kind of sadness, any kind of, like, negative emotions, because I want to be a positive, like, spectacle for you guys. Like, I want you guys to look at me as a sense of positivity and be positive for your day. But I mean, dude, there's times where I just fucking don't want to wake up. There's times, and I don't even know why. That's the thing. Like, that's how my brain works sometimes, and that's how a lot of men's brains works. That's how a lot of people's brains work, but this is more like centralized to men based on this song. That's how a lot of people and a lot of men are. And it's crazy because it's so glanced over in the public eye.
A broken heart, yeah. As a man, we gotta pave our way. Our only function is to work and slave. There's no respect for you if you ain't paid. You're disregarded as a human and you can't complain. And if you ever make it up and actually reach that place and find a woman that you love and give her your last name, you'll feel the things that you provide is only why she stays. And when you try to explain, you'll say, I can't hide myself. I don't expect you to understand. I just hope I can explain what it's like to be a man. It's a lonely road. And they don't care about what you know. It's not about how you feel, but what you provide inside that home.
Man, you can see it in the actor's eyes. They're doing a great job at that. But just like seeing the mental terror that is on his body right now from being a truck driver all night, doing these jobs that not a lot of people want to do. That's like notoriously men jobs, driving trucks all night, or being in a welder. That was another job that we saw right there. It really is crazy. The mental tasks that can be taken on people with kinds of jobs like that. And again, Dax is saying it spot on. Like, you don't really have anybody to talk to. Like, you just sit there alone and you kind of deal with it yourself. If you're lucky in life, you can find a woman that's very understanding of that. Like, I'm very fortunate that my lady is very understanding whenever I get in my feels. Sometimes I just fucking lay in bed and I'll cry next to her and she's just there. Like, she understands. I don't do it often, but like, she understands. Like, sometimes I just got to let it out. I'll have memories of my grandma who's been passed away for 4.5 years now. And like, it still feels like it just happened. And I'll just lay in bed and cry and she'll be right there with me because she understands. So if you're lucky in life, you find somebody like that, that understands. But a lot of the times, like, if you are crying in bed, you looked at as a bitch, like, straight up. Like, that's just how it is. You're not allowed to have those kinds of feelings if you want to be respected as a man. And I'm fucking with this song heavy because of the, like, it's just relatable for me. I'm not trying to get pity. I'm not trying to be like, oh, look at me. I get sad feelings sometimes. I'm a man. It's not about that. This is about, like, pay the fuck attention, okay? Let me have a moment of crying time and not call me a bitch for it, not judge me for it. I'm ranting like a motherfucker. But yeah, that's how I'm feeling right now.
It's not about how you feel, but what you provide inside that home. Don't give up, keep fighting. As a man, our sun is our horizon. And our father's actions play a role, and we end up like them.
I just want to say, I like that bar right there, that our sun is our horizon. Double entendre for the actual sun horizon, but our physical sun, our sun from our seed, is our horizon, is our sunset, is our bright light.
Let's play a role and we end up like them. So they can't let us see them hurt, because we'll embody what they do and start a generational curse. No wonder most men are so depressed. All the things that they can't express. They go to war, get thrown on the shelf, then go back to war with their mental health. Then grab that bottle and ask for help.
That's a bar right there. They go to war, get thrown on the shelf, come back to war with their mental health. I know so many veterans that deal with PTSD. And again, there's just like nothing for them. Like, they literally fought to keep us free. And then they come back and get completely disrespected. Or like, they have to deal with the fact that maybe they killed somebody. Or maybe they were away from their family for 4 years, which is a long fucking time to be away from people that you love. And then they come back and have to deal with all of this stuff in their head. And they just have nowhere to go. Like, it's crazy, man. It really is crazy. That's why, I mean, veterans are like the leading suicide. Male veterans are leading cases of suicide because of all this stuff that happens. There's so many male veterans that commit suicide, and it's ridiculous.
Idle and ask for help, try to pull themselves out of hell, then fall back down and then realize that they're gonna have to do it themselves. It's the circle of life. As a man, you provide. They don't know what you're worth till the day that you die, and that's when they start crying. Then move on to a man to confide in. That's why we feel we can't hide ourselves.
Wow. They start crying the day you die, and then they move on to another man to confide them. Whether it's a father figure, a brother, or another loved one to confide in them losing another man. That's crazy, man. That's crazy. Like I said, I'm not looking for pity, and like, I'm not one of these guys like that are like super crazy advocates for mental health. I just want people to be more aware of it, for mental health and for men's mental health, because of this stuff.
We don't expect you to understand. We can explain what it's like to be human. It's a lonely road, and you don't care about what we know. It's not about how we feel, but what we provide inside that home.
I like that the last chorus varied a little.
That
more, instead of saying what they or what you, to say what we. I like this instrumental too. Wow. This is a different style of Dax than I'm used to reacting to. I'm used to reacting to like super bar heavy stuff. But shout out to my guy, man. I like this song. I like the message behind this song, and I approve. It is your boy Crypt approved. Let me know how you guys felt about this song. Like I said, I really respect it, and I like the message, and I hope a lot of people can learn something from the song, really. You know, if you are a man and you're dealing with some stuff, there are avenues to reach out. I mean, there are therapists, there are like other men friends. I mean, I know, like I said, I talked with my boxing coach earlier. Sometimes he'll have a retreat where it's only guys and they go out to a cabin somewhere in the woods and they literally just fucking cry. They sit in a cabin, tell everybody their problems, every man their problems, because as a man, we relate to another man's problems and we all just sit there and fucking cry. I haven't gone to one, but I might end up going to one, but I know he has those. And so there are avenues for you to just let it all out. Try not to hold it in. Don't drink. That is the biggest no-no. Do not fucking drink to subsidize that problem, because that goes down a very horrible road. Yeah, just reach out, man. Just reach out to anybody that you can. Try not to hold that shit in, because that's where things get very, very bad. But that's it for my rant. I love you guys. I appreciate anybody that's watching this video. Shout out to my guy, Dax. And until next video, it's been your boy, Crypt, and I'm signing out. I love you guys. Here I go, cause it's all I know, and there's comfort in being a heart.